Hello, welcome to Fundo Tester. This is a continuation of a test sigma tutorial. In previous session we had a discussion of how we can automate get request, post request, put request, delete request on a test sigma platform without writing a single line of code. But there we have used so many times hard-coded values, and in real time if we are writing a script and we are developing a stuff for a product, then we are not using a hard-coded stuff there. So in this we are going to discuss how we can use a dynamic environment URL for API automation. So let's get started, and before moving forward, don't forget to like and share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Fundo Testers.
Camera rolling, action.
So here I am on a test sigma dashboard. Previous session we have automated put and delete request. So if you haven't watched the video, you can go to the description section, or I have linked here as well on card. Here basically I'm going to edit the test, and here you can see we have used a hard-coded URL. But in real time what happens? Endpoint will be similar for environment to environment. Let's say I'm going to execute on a test environment or dev environment or a staging or whatever environment I'm going to run my test. For APIs, endpoint will be a common, but base URI will change. So here we have used a hard-coded base URI that is not a valid. If I have to execute this test on a different environment, then later on I have to, every time I have to edit all the test and I have to update the base URI. This is not a fruitful stuff. So what we can do, we are going to set this as an environment URL. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to simply copy this URL up to the .in. I'm copy this. We have to go to test development, and here there is option to set an environment. So I'm going to create an environment, and here I'm going to, let's say we are running a test on a testing environment. So I'm giving a name, testing environment, and here we have to provide the things, if description or anything apart from what are the data we are going to use this particular environment. So let's say I have a URL and we have to specify the value. Apart from, let's say we have username or password or any other data. So for example, username, let's say I have Nishant and I have a password. So these three values we have for each and every environment. So let's say password is test@123. So what we have to do, we have to just create an environment, and later on environment has been created, and whenever we wanted to update, we can update this environment as well. So again I'm going to a test test cases, and we are going to update for this test. Basically we have to edit a step, so I'm going to each and every steps, and here this up to dot end, this is a base URI. I have to simply write a star to pipeline symbol and whatever value we wanted to pass. So there are three values: username, password, and URL. So here I am going to use a URL. So URL is a dynamic stuff here. So now I am going to use same for a delete request as well. So I am going to edit again, and now I am going to update a URL. So star and two pipeline symbol, and in between we have to write a URL. So this is pretty much updated, and now if I am going to run this test, so there is an option to select the environment. So here I have to select multiple environment are available. So let's say dev environment, test environment, we have updated for a testing environment. So now I have to select test environment, and I have to run the test. So first test is a pass, second test is somehow failing, response status is not expected as per the expected response, but this one is passed. So we can see we have not specified here the base URI. It is directly coming from a test environment, and it is basically merging a string, and we are able to execute a test. Now let's say we wanted to try for invalid data, and then again we are going to an environment, and instead of passing valid URI, we are passing some random data, let's say XYZ. This test should fail. So again, I'm going to a test cases, that particular test I'm navigating to, and if I execute now, then put request itself, it will fail. Delete request will get skipped. So let's execute, run. We are selecting a test environment already pre-selected, and let me click on the run button. So now we can see first has failed and second has been skipped. Error message, test execution has failed. So this is how we can execute our API test on a multiple environments on a test sig using a dynamic data. So I hope this video is helpful, and moving forward, don't forget to like and share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Fundo Testers.